Hello, everybody. Scott here, and there's another October special for October and your Halloween mood. So, I recently made a video where I ranked the three best Dracula movies, at least in my opinion. You probably have a different opinion, and that's okay. But then I said that there was a new Netflix series about Dracula, called basically Dracula, with the try watching. So, I did watch it, and oh man. In that other video, I said that this is how it would probably be really authentic to the original novel. I took wrong. I took it deeply wrong. So yeah, I watched the movie, and now the TV show, and it was something of its own. As I understood, it was the same creators who made the Sherlock Holmes TV show, which apparently was good too. And in this show, there were only 3 episodes, where each episode was like 1.5 hour. Way too long for my taste, but I managed to do it. In the beginning, it was pretty authentic to the original novel. We had Jonathan Harker, who went to Dracula to help him buy some properties in England, and then gets trapped. And they also included a lot from the tour to England, but after that they changed everything. It was a really surprising show, so I won't spoil too much, at least not the third episode, because the third episode was the most sucking part. You would never guess what happened. I could not do it. But I can tell some of the things. We have first off Dracula and a nun who is called Agatha. Her last name is a secret. And Dracula, when you first meet him, he's an old man, but he's sucking the life out of Jonathan Harker and becomes younger and learns more English so that he can fit in more to England. This was pretty much authentic to the novel, I think. They at least did the same thing in Bram Stoker's Dracula. But the thing that really impressed me was the fact that they really made the story's detail in Bram Stoker's Dracula. It just happened, and the whole thing seemed a little bit weird, but here they really made it detailed. There were some moments which just left me hanging there. Just a quick spoiler, there was one scene where Jonathan Harker was really weak, that he didn't even recognize his own fiancé, Mina, and then he heard this baby cry from a basket Dracula had, and he constantly asked why there was a baby screaming, and Dracula just said, there's no baby, and then he just leave the room. That whole scene was mind-blowing. And like something that both impressed me and annoyed me was that the characters was way more lifelike. Agatha was arrogant. I didn't like that though. She was a good character, but some parts just became annoying. She was pretty childish in some of the scenes. At some point she even mocked Dracula like a little child. Not so much grown-up stuff there. And Dracula too, he wasn't that dark, mysterious figure as we see in all the other movies and Dracula adaptations. He was way more lifelike and talked a lot. He talked like a human, he acted like a human. He was sometimes humble, he sometimes made mistakes, but he wasn't so silent and dark. And that was something I both liked and disliked. Because I kind of really like when he is this dark, mysterious figure. I think that Gary Oldman, who played him in Bram Stoker's Dracula, made a great combination between a talking, lifelike figure, but also this dark, mysterious Lord of Darkness. While here they just made him a normal human. But that doesn't mean that he didn't do a good job. he did a great job. He was really sophisticated and sadistic, I think. At one point, this isn't so much of a spoiler, but at one point, one of the characters are turned into dusk, and everyone is sucked, but the Dracula, he just goes over and step on the dust and try to remove the flames, like he didn't care at all. And the thing with this show is that there are tons of different adaptations of the Dracula novel, and most of them are the same. He goes to England, he do this and you do that, so you never get surprised anymore of what is going to happen. But in this show, they really thought out of the box. You never expect what's happening, and some of the scene that you have already seen many times still feel pretty dark and suspenseful. I mean, like, I have already seen three different Dracula movies, so I know the drill, but here they drilled somewhere else. So you will, without a doubt, become surprised of things here and there, and sucked when you find out of different alternates version they are made in this one. But now I'm just starting to go in a circle here, and of course I can't spoil so much, but one thing that I have to tell you to do is to watch that show. It's only three episodes, and it's still October, so it fits perfectly. It's not scary and so much, so for all young children there, just watch it. And for all you adults too, watch it. Because it's really suspenseful. So, and you will probably, without a doubt, get sucked here and there. So, thank you for watching this video. As I said, I've already made a Dracula movie earlier this month. You can find it right here. And I've also made some other October videos, which you can find here. And you can find my channel right here, and some videos here. I'll see you next time. Good October.